Ross Russell and her husband, who was the Broadway producer called Freddie Brisson. And what I say in the book, sort of a slightly mean thing. I mean, everyone loved Roz Russell. She was a wit. She was a lady. And nobody liked Freddie, really. And they used to call him the Lizard of Roz.
Yeah. The other person who is here, well, here is, I have to tell you, Roddy McDowell and his beach party. It's thanks to Roddy saying to Bernie Brillstein, you really should write down your stories, that his book has just come out.
Yeah.
And this is the gala time.
Yeah.
The beautiful people in Malibu.
In Malibu. It's Paul Newman, there's Sean Connery and myself, Tony Perkins. Down here is the great, divine Simone Signoret talking to Hugh French, who was her agent. There is Roddy. I can't see who he's talking to. Next is Julie Andrews and her little girl, who is now very grown up, and then Jane Fonda, and above Kirk Douglas, and then Paul Newman. And that was a typical Sunday lunch at Roddy McDowell's.
Yeah. Nick, when did the drinking start?
The drinking started after this. I mean, and after that, I mean, it was a few years later that I began to feel that I didn't belong in the world. My social accomplishments exceeded my workplace accomplishments, if you understand what I mean. And I, you know, I was not on a par with the people that I was traveling with.
Yeah.
And I began to feel insecure with myself, and I didn't. And that's when it started.
Was it Lenny's money you were living on then?
Then you were earning
the money too.
Oh, I earned big.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
I mean,
it wasn't that
I don't know. I just began to lose confidence in myself. I mean, I went on for a long time and produced a lot of pictures.
Let's talk about some of those you produced. Boys in the Band.
Yeah.
Elizabeth Taylor's film.
Ash Wednesday.
Yeah.
That was my last film. That was the film that did me in. That by that time, I was a drunk.
Yeah.
And I was a drugger. And Elizabeth said to me, we did that film in Italy in Cortina d'Ampezzo, amazing life experience, which would be a great film, better than the film that we made.
Yeah.
And she said to me one night in the bar, you know, Dominic, this is going to be the last movie you're ever going to produce. And she was right. She was right.
Yeah.
That was the end for me.
Of the work that you did, what sort of stands out that you say I was proud of that?
Well, I'm, you know, except for that movie, I'm kind of proud of all.
Yeah.
They're very distinguished movies. I mean, the Boys in the Band was a very distinguished movie.
Yeah.
The Panic in Needle Park was with Al Pacino, his first starring role, and it won the prize at the Cannes Film Festival.
Then what was the cause of you not feeling?
I don't know, but I felt I was there in a pass. I truly did. And I didn't have the feeling that I was, as a producer, in charge, really.
Yeah.
And it was an odd feeling. It was, and I also began to feel, you know, all my life I'd wanted to be in Hollywood. I'd wanted to live the glamorous life. I wanted to be part of it. And I got it.
Yeah.
And I got it. And then I got to be a producer,
four-star.
Elizabeth 20th. Taylor.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, something happened. It was like, this isn't it.
Yeah.
What I thought I always wanted, I got it.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't it.
Is that all there is, my friend?
Yeah. And so then I really began to self-destruct. And, I finally... I left here like a whipped dog.
Yeah, your tail between your legs.
Yeah, I mean, out, over, things.
And
went to Oregon. And my car broke down in a little town called Camp Sherman. And I rented a tourist cabin for the night. And I stayed there for 6 months.
Yeah. And there were a marvelous couple who were really good to you.
Yeah, they were good to me.
This is a far cry from Walden Drive.
A far
cry. Yeah.
But you know something? that 6 months that I spent in that cabin, without a telephone, without a television set, alone. And I'm a guy who's gone to parties every night of his life.
Yeah.
And
what about now?
What about now?
Do you go to a party every night?
I go out, yeah, a lot, but it's a different thing now. I mean, this is what I write about.
And, couple that you do have a picture of, and I'd never seen what he looked like. A man that really was renowned in Hollywood, Sidney Korshak.
Sidney Korshak. He was the lawyer for the Teamsters. And there was a great deal of stories about Sidney Korshak. And what I never knew when I would bring my camera to these parties, I never knew that Sidney Korshak was never, ever photographed. And I have about 3 different pictures of him.
There's another one, too, of a man named Belden Cattleman. And here he is with Tony Curtis. But you have just a couple of lines that you know what a man is like. You said he bought the same dress from Galanos for his wife and his mistress.
To wear to the same party.
Yeah.
It was one of the most bizarre things I ever saw.
I mean, those are the sort of little quirks, Nick, that when you remember, you don't have to worry about finding character traits for a character when you're writing a novel.
Yeah, yeah. That's a great touch, that one. But he was an interesting guy, Belden. He had mafia connections and a nice wife, and he moved here, and he wanted to get in with the movie crowd. And he's the guy, they say, who burnt down El Rancho Vegas for the insurance money, mm-hmm. and that's what he was living on. And he bought the Gary Cooper house, and he played poker there. And remember that thing when he had the guys above yeah. with the holes?
I thought that was at the Friars.
Yeah,
spot.
But he also had it in his house.
Yeah.
And he gave signals to him during the games. He was an interesting man. He got me out of a jam, though.
Which jam?
Well, I mean, I was arrested for bringing drugs from Mexico to here, and I was put in jail.
It was marijuana.
Marijuana. And he got me out of it. I mean, he heard that I was in trouble, and he called. And I asked him, I said, why? Why did you do that? I didn't know him that well. And he said, when we first came to this town and nobody spoke to us at the parties, you always did.
That was an interesting part. Talk about the beautiful people, but that experience in the jail with
the killer.
And the toilet backs up. And, I mean, the horror of having to go through that.
The worst part was when I was handcuffed behind me and taken through the waiting room of Western Airlines with a big, tall cop on each side of me with their hand under the arm, and they lifted me up off the floor so that my feet weren't touching the floor, which is not a great look.
Yeah.
And thousands of people were lined up to watch, and 2 of my 3 children were there.
Oh.
And saw me like that. And it's always been a great shame of my life.
Yeah, that you don't get over easy, or ever, but at least there is the phoenix can rise out of the ashes.
Yeah.
Ronald and Nancy Reagan at a luncheon party.
That picture was taken before the governorship.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it shows that whatever they have together, it was there from the from the beginning.
And the other people there?
At over there to the left, on the left of the page is Betsy Bloomingdale. And then the 2 guys talking to each other are Ray Stark, the producer, and Alfred Bloomingdale. Now later, I wrote a novel called An Inconvenient Woman based on Alfred Bloomingdale's affair with his mistress.
Where he died. Didn't
yeah,
he die
he
in
died.
Her, like Rockefeller?
No.
No, he
no.
didn't die there.
No.
Yeah.
But he died.
And she sued the estate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He had promised to take care of her.
Yeah.
And then never changed his will.
So she.
And then she was murdered.
Mm-hmm.